Yeah. amazing grace. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Get me out of it.
Could have left us from Jerry.
Yeah, sure.
Somebody stand up and testify.
You know, all the troubles that we're going through, I know he's faithful and he's working all these things.
Dig some ditches.
Yes. Come on.
I don't talk very much. I listen a lot.
Yes, sir.
Very much I listen. The Tuesday, that'll be 10 years, my grandson was born.
Yes, sir.
When he was born, we had to rush him to a children's hospital in New Orleans. He was born with not a full heart.
My goodness.
They brought him down there. They did an observation. And they had doctors work on him and reconstruct his heart. Put in veins where they're not supposed to, where they're not supposed to.
Yes, sir.
They help him out. He's done had three surgeries. And every time he's had a surgery, he's came out perfect.
Amen.
The doctors did the work, but the man of status.
Yes. Yes.
He's done at Mentor Hospital checking his kid. His birthday is going to be Tuesday.
Great.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
and I bumped Sister Teresa. I said, what's the name of that song? And she said, that secret place. So that was what Sister Bonnie used to sing.
Yes, it was.
My, my, my. Lord, 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 what a day that's going to be.
Yes.
I wish y'all had an opportunity to meet Sister Bonnie. Amen. I want to tell you, what many like Sister Bonnie. Glory to God. So love her. What she stood for.
Yes.
God.
Yes.
Amen. Well, it looked like a good majority of them must have got all their trouble fixed this morning. We're going to go right back there. I'd asked the Lord in prayer today when I got home, and it was a lot of uncovered ground. I want you to go to Acts chapter 20. Amen. I did not tell the church outside of why y'all wasn't here. Just said they're just like the rest of us. We inviting trouble.
Yes.
Not amongst themselves.
No.
But I want to tell you that that devil's relentless, is he not?
Yes.
Amen. Yes. With this thought tonight, when the uproar ceases, God will still be God.
Yes.
And you and I can still have the victory.
Amen.
Glory to God. Man, I want to tell you there's such a liberty in this place this morning.
Yes.
Man, it's good to have liberty on a Sunday morning. Glory to God. Amen. Acts chapter 20. Is this too loud?
No, sir.
No, sir.
All right. And after the uproar was ceased, Paul called unto him the disciples and embraced them and departed for to go into Macedonia. Lord, continue this thought tonight. Pray, hide me behind your cross and speak words of life. Lord, speak words, even to that video camera, Lord, that when somebody begins to watch this, that's maybe at home, sick, afflicted, downcast, troubled, whatever the problem might be, that they can be encouraged, Lord.
Yes,
I feel your presence here tonight. We so appreciate, Lord,
yes,
God, that you would, God, consider us, Lord, and come and be with us, oh God, in spirit, Lord. God, let us magnify you in everything we say and do, Lord.
Yes.
Hide us behind your glorious cross. Meet every need in this sanctuary tonight and all points abroad, we pray now. We ask this and pray this in Jesus' wonderful name. And the churches shout amen tonight.
Amen.
God. Amen. Won't cover or recover a bunch tonight, but understand what brought them the uproar. The Bible says it was confusion. They was... Some therefore cried one thing in Acts 19 and 32, and some another thing. For the assembly was confused, and the more part, most of them didn't even know wherefore they were even there. What a horrible, horrible picture this is painted.
Wow.
Amen. When people just gathers up and they really don't have a direction, and
yeah.
I come on somebody, it's this one day and that the next. This is what we need to do today, and by this time next week, we ain't doing nothing. Amen. And the confusion is a terrible, terrible thing.
Right.
Amen. Confusion is a very strong tool in the arsenal of the adversary. If he can get people's mind confused, he'll get their mind off of God. And as long as we can keep our mind stayed upon the Lord, I'm going to tell you there's victory, folks. There's victory in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. There's victory in the Lord's church tonight. Amen. We got down as far as this. In John chapter 18 and 19, were a time filled with trouble. And we simply said in those two chapters, you'll find Judas is going to betray the Lord. You're going to find Peter denying the Lord. And then you're even going to find Jesus himself was going to depart. from his congregation because something had to be fulfilled there. Let me tell you, friend, like we preached not long ago, if the Lord's cloud is to lead you and he'll set that cloud on fire at night, if you ever see it relocating, repositioning, don't let your heart be troubled. He's just relocating, amen, into a different position that he can fight the enemy, amen, for your behalf tonight. Don't think he's going to leave you. Don't think he's going to forsake you because the word of God is true. In fact, the Bible said, let every man be a liar, but let the word of God be so. I wonder tonight how many can lift your hand and say, I know the word of God is true. Amen. You can question a lot of things. You can doubt maybe some things, but don't ever question or doubt the word of God. I mean, it's truth, friend. It's truth. So we get to this place, trouble. Trouble has been has the potential to cause our mind to think that we've been abandoned. Mm-hmm. Even the psalmist, in chapter 10, verse 1, he writes, why standest thou afar off, O Lord? Why hidest thou self in times of trouble? Now, I know us as good, faithful people of the Lord, we probably never thought nothing like that. Unless we're real, we can say, you know, at times we felt like we was all alone. Oh, yeah. Have you ever just felt like you was just so bewildered in loneliness when you was in a room full of people? Yeah. Have you ever felt like maybe the Lord had just kind of checked out on you and just left you to fight this own battle? But that's what that old humanistic mind, that carnal mind that tries to persuade you and I that God's not all that he says he is and that he doesn't care like he says he does. But that's when you got to stand flat-footed on the solid principles of the Lord Jesus Christ and say, oh no, the Word says. I said, the Word says. Come on. Do you remember when the Lord stepped onto that boat with those disciples and said, let us go to the other side? There's going to be a storm. There's going to be some questioning. There's going to be some fear in the boat, but none of it come from the Lord. Why? Because he said he'd give us a direction and a position and a proposal. Let us go. He's included in everything you and I do. Let us go to that other side. So easily we get our focus off. And like the word said this morning, we'll get our focus more on the problem than the promise. And the Lord's made us some wonderful promises. And then testimony, like Brother Kenneth testified a while ago. Man, I want to tell you, that just reassures, that reasserts in you and I that the God's still God. He's still a healing Jesus, right? Remember the old song, he's a healing Jesus? Listen, Jesus said trouble would come. He also said that trouble didn't have to trouble us. Now, I ain't there yet. Boy, pick that stone up and hurl it this way. But I'm going to tell you, sometimes trouble's got a way of troubling us, does it not? Yes, it does. Amen. Yes. But you know, that don't make you backslid. Don't make you a bad Christian. It just makes you real. Because again, that was Jesus on the boat with his disciples. And they got all kind of trouble in their mind, in their spirit, in their heart. Glory to God. Listen now, Jesus knew that trouble had the ability to cause distress, anxiety, worry, fear, and doubt, to name a few. He knew this. But this is one of the reasons why he told us to stay full of the Spirit of God.
All right.
Man, I want to tell you, Xanax is not the answer.
Come on,
somebody. I want to tell you, Percocet or whatever them other things that idle you way down. Let me tell you, friend, what we need, you and I need, is a good dose of Jesus. A good dose of the Holy Ghost. Amen. To calm the troubled waters. Amen. Friend, listen, that adversary, I want to tell you, I'm not preaching against medicine, so y'all go ahead and get the thing out of you, get the Get it out of your craw now. But what I'm telling you, we take too much medicine. Come on. Oh, hallelujah. Listen, when I was out in the arena of the world, when I wanted to get happy, I took a pill.
Yeah.
When I wanted to work hard and fast, I took more pills.
Yeah.
When I wanted to sleep, I took more pills. With whatever kind of mood I wanted to be in, they sold a pill. And it was usually sold out of a black suitcase out of the trunk of a car or something. I'm not bragging on that, but I like pills. Amen. But what's happened, that same mentality we bring over to the newness of Christ now, and if not careful, we'll believe that we gotta have that over him. Glory to God. He's still the way maker. Come on. He's still the sea walker. I know we got troubles, but don't be troubled. What causes trouble? You ever thought about that? Somebody might say, well, you cause it right now. there's three things real quick. Things we hear. Matthew 24 and 6, the Lord said, and ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. But this is what, I love this. He said, see that ye not be troubled.
That's right.
I don't no more. We'll glue down on them news channels.
No.
That propaganda, that spew lies. And why don't they ever show some good news?
All right.
Huh?
It don't sell.
I read something a while ago. Home Depot and one of the Tennessee Home Depots, a worker, he's going down the aisle and he sees the little bank envelopes when you make a little deposit or get a little cash back. One laying in the middle of the floor. He opened that thing up, it had seven $100 bills in it. It was back in the holiday season. He brought that up to management and said, hey, we got an issue. We got this envelope here. We need to get it back to the right hands.
Yeah.
Well, now, you post on the internet that you just found seven $100 bills. Everybody's going to.
Oh, yeah.
You just thought they're going to be a charismatic. They're going to claim that.
Yeah.
But there was some writing on there. So this manager posted out there on the Facebook and all the social media sites that it was just found this envelope, and it's got some discreet, it had some initials of a man's name and stuff from there, and it went to almost the very end of the shift, and all of a sudden the guy come up. He said, that's my money. You tell me about it. What's on that envelope? And he told her, and she said, well, come on and get your money. He was on his way. He'd been to all them stores, Christmas shopping for his kids, and he was on his way, and he lost that money. And I commend that man, the worker that found that. How easy would it be, huh? He brought that, and why don't they put that on the news? Listen, friend. Things we hear sometimes will bring on trouble. But listen, Jesus said, see that you not be troubled. For all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Boy, they've been telling us about the end of the world for a long time. There's been 1,700 antichrists already pointed to and said that still ain't got him yet. Amen. We get caught into the sticky web of society. Basically, it becomes society gossip. Amen. We almost believe everything Google says. They done a survey the other day. They said the five worst places to get your information. You know what number one was? Google. Glory to God. That's exactly that. Listen, my God, I want to tell you, I'd rather get my information from the Word of God.
Right.
Come on. Is anybody still having any trouble? Glory to God. Well, friend, listen. The second thing that's got the potential of causing trouble is things we see. Mark 6 and 50, the Lord said, for they all saw him and were troubled. And immediately he talked with them.
Yeah.
And he said unto them, the Lord said, be of good cheer, it is I, be not afraid. You know, the thing sometimes that you see that's hard to believe, Help me, Lord. You know, Joe Blow been an alcoholic and a drunk and a dope head all his life. He staggers into the church one night, falls in an old altar of repentance. He gets miraculously born again, but half the congregation says it won't last. So he gets out, and all they couldn't explain, because the ways of the Lord is higher than our ways. Oh, come on, the truths of the Word of God is not comprehensible to a natural mind. That's why you got to read it in the Holy Ghost. That's why you got to absorb it by the ways of the Spirit, friend. Because you try to read it carnally, you can't understand it. But get impregnated with the power of God, and that thing will open up to you. Hallelujah. You know what else causes trouble? The third thing? The past.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Right. Exes. Anybody got any exes? I don't listen to country music. I didn't listen to country music when I was in the world. Listen, I was just bound to something different. But I remember working around these guys. They all got a radio and nobody wanted to play gospel music.
No.
They'd get all rowdied up when they were that one. Something about exes in Texas. Glory to God. I said, I guess that's why Texas has got to be so big, because it's got that. Hallelujah. But what I'm saying, I'm not talking about your marital status now. I'm talking about your past. The things that you had to divorce.
Come on, sorry.
The things you had to leave behind. Because it ain't going to fit in the new way. What's wrong with people in the church? They still yoked up. And it really is an ex in the church. But when they get out into that world, they yoke back up with it. You got to be unequally yoked. Come on, somebody. I'm here to tell you, you got to give it all to God. Break loose and break free from that.
Yeah.
Woo!
All right.
I'm not doing no marriage seminar tonight. But I'm going to tell you, divorce is an ugly thing.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is. Amen. It seems like, amen, yeah. It goes on and on and on and on, and no. Children get involved, and it's a horrible thing. Amen. But again, I'm not talking about man and woman right here getting a marriage. I'm talking about just the things we were associated with, things that still tries to...
Come on.
Oh, I know you sanctified tonight. Come on. But I'm going to tell you, you know, I guess you know, maybe you don't, maybe I'm just on by myself.
No, sir.
That every once in a while wakes up in a cold sweat.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That still got to stomp the other toe when it gets to tapping.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
When you're shopping at Walmart.
Come on.
Oh, you're going to help me. That's all right. Huh? The things that wants to follow you around and always pursue you to see what else they can get from you.
Yeah, yeah. That's good.
Man, I feel the Holy Ghost dealing with somebody right now.
Yeah.
Amen. Listen. Look diligently, lest any man fail from the grace of God. Lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you. And thereby meaning... be defiled. Friend, I want to tell you, you never going to reach a day in your Christian life that something ain't going to try to pull on you and pull you backwards.
Right.
Huh? Friend, I'm here to tell you tonight that the devil will use anything or anybody he can to keep you from your fulfilling the purpose that God's got for you. Do you know that y'all all got purpose?
Yes.
Y'all know that?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Listen, some went looking for trouble. For some, trouble would find them.
Yeah.
Trouble can come from our thoughts, our decisions, our actions, or over what others do or we feel they don't do. Can I tell you, keep your eyes on the prize.
Yeah.
You can give somebody a lot of advice, But you can't do what the Lord has already accomplished at Calvary.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
And if we're not careful, listen to this. If we're not careful, we'll spend more time concerned with somebody else's affairs than our own.
Come on.
Man, the Holy Ghost is in the house right now.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Come on,
I love this. I love just to be instructed by the Spirit of God. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Well, did you hear?
Come on.
Did you see?
Right.
And all that time when we should have been praying and getting the mind of God.
Yes.
We're trying to figure out. We all put on a detective badge, and we all try to figure things out. We jump to conclusions.
All right.
Hey, you know what? As a young preacher, what used to get me every time until I finally wised up to it. I found myself preaching to one or two in a congregation of 100 because I didn't feel like they were with me. Now, most of you won't know what I'm talking about there. If you've ever been called to God to preach and minister and evangelize, especially evangelize, you get that idiot back on that back row over there. I mean, I want to tell you. And you fool around and God really growed me and helped me because I was failing in that. It wasn't that I wasn't preaching a word, but I got sidetracked, you know. That would get in my mind. And because I wanted to see the Lord move on everybody. But that Yahoo back there, I'm going to tell you, he knew he's getting to me. So I'll tell you what I did the next morning when I finally saw this thing broke out of my life is when I got there really early. Amen. How many still believe in prayer?
Yes. Yes.
Huh?
Amen.
Thanks, Lord.
Got there really early. The next morning, we were in a camper just right close down the road and got there and just prayed and prayed and prayed through, and the Lord instructed me. Hallelujah. And I found out something then. The Lord said, if you can't keep your eyes and your mind straight, you find a spot on the wall back there and you preach to that spot. Glory to God. Brother Chad, well, I'm matured now. It used to be a spot or a bug or whatever it was. But now I can just look at them eyeball to eyeball. Come on, somebody, and give them help. Glory to God. But that, listen, friend, but that trouble, nobody ever wants to go through it.
Uh-oh.
But how many knows that Jesus himself, is this life is full of trouble.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. Our thoughts, our decisions, our actions. Can you recall any time in your life since you've been born again that you was wrong?
Yeah.
Well, not everybody's agreeing, man. Not everybody's laughing. Not everybody's like, woo. I'm telling you, you was wrong.
Yeah.
We were wrong sometimes when we thought we were right.
Yes.
We thought we knew the whole story. Come on. We thought we saw it all. We thought, amen, and that's what that name of the leper thought, didn't he? When he went and went to the man of God's house and knocked on the door. He's heard about this man. Now, oh man, this fixed to be the marching band's gonna come out from his house and the trumpet's gonna blow and the man of God's gonna come out there and strike his hand across the old leper. But guess what? He thought, but it didn't happen. He sent his little servant out there and said, go dip yourself in the muddy Jordan River 7 times and you'll be clean. Oh, hallelujah. How many knows that if not careful, we think that when we find out it ain't going the way we thought, we can't have it as well as we should have. But can I tell you, don't be troubled in the time of your trouble. That's why the Word of God says make your calling in election sure. Glory to God. Oh, Luke 10:40-42. Oh, Martha. That old sister Martha, she's a worker.
Yeah.
She was cumbered about much serving. And she came to Jesus. He was there at the house. They was going to have a meal and he was going to break the spiritual bread. And he's preaching and teaching in there. So she was cumbered. Her mind's all confused and twisted now. She's doing a good work. But she said, Lord, doest thou not care that my sister hath left me to serve by myself? For the word says alone.
And then she says this to the Lord, bid her therefore that she help me. Boy, that's a, she just tattled on her sister, didn't she? This is grown women I'm talking about now. This ain't 10-year-olds with ribbons in their hair. This is grown people. Amen. But she allowed this thing to gnaw at her. This is how it plays out. Jesus is there. They got a meal prepared. He's in there teaching. People's hanging just on every word he's saying. They crowded through any window or opening where they could hear the word.
Right.
The place was packed with excitement. And Martha was trying to get it all together. Dear God, oh, I don't know if we're going to have enough food. And I just don't know. And, well, there she is. There's Mary. There's my sister right there. Come on, somebody. You know.
Yes.
You know how we get sometimes and we don't feel like somebody else is contributing to the cause.
Yes.
Come on.
Yeah.
Huh? So there she is. So now she's got one or two things she can do. She can continue on and just set the table, get everything ready, do what she needed to do. Or she can take the low road. And that's what she did. It did not make her a chief sinner. It didn't make her a bad person. It made her a real person. Because you and I gets that pouty spirit every once in a while too. Listen, but this is what happened. Oh, Lord. She's left me. She's left me. Don't you even care that she left me? I'm by myself. I'm working my fingers to the bone. Everybody else is getting her in joy. Everybody's hearing the word. Won't you just get her to help me? And Jesus turned and he looked into her and he says, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things.
Right.
He said, but one thing's needful.
That's it.
Yes.
And Mary has chosen that good part.
Yes, yes.
Which shall not be taken away from her. You know, I've always gleaned that. That's why I don't like having a cook while the word of God's being preached, when the spirit of God's being moved. Amen. You know, we try to get it all done and get it ready, but let me tell you, a plate of cold food won't kill nobody. Amen. I'd rather eat a cold meal than have 3 or 4 or 5 people over there slaving and doing all that, getting it ready, but miss the most important part of the service. Let me tell you, that fried chicken or whatever, spaghetti or jambalaya, whatever it's going to be, it can only nurture the natural. But the word of God feeds the soul, the spirit. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah, somebody. But what Jesus was just trying to tell her, listen, Martha, you could have just lay it all down and listened to the word, and then you would have plenty of help coming. But we get things in our minds, so I'm trying not to pastor tonight. But we get things in our minds about the way it should be, and then when we see it's not, we jump to conclusions and watch out, or we would say, oh, but if I was doing it,
come on.
Come on. Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
Listen, one thing is needful.
Right.
As much trouble that came in John chapter 18 and 19, trouble speaks to give way to triumph in chapters 20 and 21.
All right.
Some good stuff went on there. The psalmist writes in chapter 27, 4 and 5, he said, one thing have I desired of the Lord, one thing that will I seek after. And this is what he says, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock.
Right.
Kind of like that song, glory to God. Man, there's a secret place. There's a place, glory to God, that only you and the Lord can go. It's a time to shut the door on the problems, on the pain, on the situation. It's time to shut the door on the circumstance. Be like that widow woman. Take them two boys and go into that room and close the door. You've got what you need in that room. They've already borrowed the vessels. You've got a little bit of all, and the Lord's provision. nation. It's fixing to show you a supernatural miracle. But he said this. This is what's important. Close the door. Don't let the noise come in. Don't let the aggravation come in. Don't let the complaint come in. Close the door. That's why it's called a prayer closet. Oh, come on. In the prayer closet, you can get your answer. Hallelujah. That pavilion. Gonna set me upon a rock, and that rock is Christ. Glory to God. All, every person in that Bible faced trouble.
Oh, yeah.
You have trouble. We said we named 100 troubles today, didn't we? Trouble on a job, trouble in a school, trouble in the house, trouble in the community, trouble at the church, huh? All these things, huh?
Yeah.
What about trouble in the family?
Oh, yes.
You ever had family trouble?
Yes.
But you know what? He's the same. The Lord's the same no matter what the trouble is.
Yes, amen.
Parents and children, mamas and daddies, relatives.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
One thing I'm learning in my life that as older as elderly people get, they kind of get set in their ways. Kind of?
Yeah.
A little bit, maybe?
Yeah. Yes.
And I know we've all said we ain't gonna be like that when we get old. Do you know what God is doing there? God is using our elderly parents as forerunners of what we're gonna be. He's letting us see. But do you know that no matter what comes and what goes, the Lord is unmoved. You know, Esau's 40 years old when he took a wife, Judith, the daughter of Bera, the Hittite, and Bashemath, the daughter of Elon, the Hittite, which was a grief of mind unto Isaac and Rebekah. Now, you might have thought you've had some bad in-laws. But when that boy said, I do, to one of those wives, because she was the daughter of Ishmael. Mm-hmm. How'd you like to have Ishmael all up in your family? Huh? And the Bible goes on to say it plagued their minds, troubled them in heart. Amen. Because they knew what that Ishmael was. Sarah and Hagar, again, mother against mother. There's problems. David and Michal in 2 Samuel chapter 6, you know. David was presented. Man, I've always thought about that, okay? Saul said, the man that kills that giant, he's going to give him his daughter. Mm-hmm. Now, just automatically, I guess everybody thought, woo, yeah, huh? Until David comes with bringing the Ark of God home. And he's dancing before the Lord, and she's up there in the window looking down and just calling him foolish.
Yes.
Huh? Brothers and sisters, Miriam and Aaron, they spake against Moses and the Ethiopian woman. Brothers. I mean, all of Joseph's, most of all of his brothers, there was war in that family. Foolish husbands, Nabal. His word, his whole name means fool or empty. Huh? Contentious wives. It's better to dwell in the wilderness than with a contentious and angry woman. Ain't you glad we ain't got no sisters like that?
Yes.
And somebody, one of these sisters right there said, well, you didn't read nothing about the man.
Amen.
Not yet. But there's so many ways that adversary will try to provoke you. I woke up out of a dream the other night, early morning, when I'm just sweating. It wasn't fever. It
wasn't COVID.
It was a dream of something I was a part of in my past. And it was so real that it caused me just to begin to sweat. And when I come to myself, when I woke up, I looked around. I said, thank you, Jesus.
Yes, sir.
That real. That past will haunt you. But there's nothing in that past can overtake you.
Amen.
That you don't give ground up to the permission. Because we got one that we walk with in the present.
Right.
That's pointing us to the future.
Yeah.
And the future looks way better than the past.
Right. Come on.
Because I'm sitting here to tell you that no amount of trouble that ever, and that sometimes you feel like it's your breaking point. But in that very moment, God just reassures you and gives you the strength that you need to know that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. It didn't say, listen, the weapon. It didn't say the arrows wasn't going to come in flight. The javelin, listen, to Saul tried to pin David to a wall with a javelin. There's fiery darts of the devil. There's all kind of pain. And here's Paul now. And God is doing a miraculous work in his life. And now he ain't the hotshot preacher that everybody wants to hear. They're wanting to kill him. They're wanting to stone him. But listen, it did not stop him. He got hindered before, but he died, but the Lord raised him back to life. And the most powerful testimony of that is that he didn't quit. He knew when he went into that street, there's going to be a riot breakout. He knew that, listen, they had to let him over the wall in a basket. It wasn't that he was running out of fear. He was running, amen, out of the respect of what that enemy just thought they could do, but the respect he had for God that he believed. He said, Lord, I'm in a tight spot, and the Lord made a way where it seemed to be none, and he put him on a ship. That's the whole method of trouble, is to get you focused on something else.
Right.
Now, one day we might graduate. We might pass a test. And we'll celebrate only to get into the next test. I could have went all night without saying that. That's what this life is. Listen to me, I'm going to quit. This life is a place of preparement for the eternity.
Yes.
That's what this life is.
Yes.
You might get rich and famous. You might get the desires of your heart, whatever you want to do. But that's not why God put you on this earth. God put you on this earth to be an ambassador for his own cause.
Amen.
He'll feed you when you're hungry. He'll clothe you when you're
naked.
He'll shelter you from the storm.
Yes.
But he has commissioned the church, the church, the body of Christ, in all of his brokenness and his lacerations and his pain and his affliction, even on Calvary, Jesus offered grace one more time.
Amen.
Forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do. Huh? We must be that representation.
Yes, amen.
Are we perfect? Absolutely not. There's perfection lives in us, and his name's Jesus. His spirit lives in us. And I want to tell you, there's no flaw in the Lord. There's no flaw. There's no flaw in the Holy Ghost. There's no flaw. Amen. Father in heaven, there's no flaw. Amen. Anytime we have a flaw or a setback, quit trying to look for an escape goat. Quit pointing a finger and just say, Lord, help me.
Right.
Help me be better through this test, Lord. Mm-hmm. Glory to God. That devil can get this pulpit off track, off center, If that devil can get the pulpit, amen, just the voice of the word, amen, at that moment, if he can get this thing so caught up in the things of the last life, the old life, come on, little by little, and not just the pulpit, the congregation, and then all of a sudden Moses now don't have 100%, amen, with everybody going the same way. There's people that break off. There's a people that always think it needs to be something different. But in all those times, amen, if we could come together as the body of Christ and love each other and pray for each other, I want to tell you, a prayer and love of God in a congregation, oh, it's going to overcome the wiles of the devil 24/7. But we all got to grow. We got one body.
Yeah.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
You know who I want to see come to this church? Mm-hmm. I want to see only people that the Holy Ghost of God sends.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yes.
Now that's hard to comprehend.
Yeah.
But it's not hard to comprehend.
No, sir.
Am I pointing a finger at anything? No, indeed not. No, indeed. Because
nope.
I've been pastoring a few years and this is just a cycle.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I told you, just about every church you pass has got, you can't see it, but it's a revolving door on that thing.
Yes.
It goes from the best thing since Jesus himself to less than a month.
Yeah.
They're all a bunch of devils.
Yeah.
Come on.
Right.
But don't be so perplexed and put out with that. Yeah, but Pastor, you don't know what they're saying about you. Probably do. Probably do. They say what they used to say.
Oh, yeah.
But come on. But that shouldn't move you. Paul said it didn't move me. Come on. Glory to God. I'm going to go, what do you think the world? Didn't you say them things about them holy roller churches when you was in the world?
Yes.
And even when you got in religion but didn't get a relationship with God, you still said them things. Man, boy, I used to, hop on one foot and imitate them old crazy preachers like that, kicking that leg up like that. And you know what the Holy Ghost did? He made me one of them. Don't apologize. Don't you apologize for love, Jesus. Don't you give an inch to that devil. You stand tall. Come on, Brother John. You stand tall and stand up for the cause of Christ. And I've said it a lot of times, and one more time, greater is he that is in you and I. All of you that is in the world, you're going to have some trouble.
Oh, yeah.
But trouble will not overtake you. I promise you. I promise you. I promise you. Let not your heart be troubled. The Master said this. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. Amen. Now this brings us to a part tonight that we need to know. Do we really believe the Lord? Man, I want to tell you, at times, that trouble is real, guys. And you're not exempt from it. Neither will you ever be exempt from it. But there's not one moment of any time, day or night, that trouble comes to you that the Lord himself won't help you. You gotta, but listen, don't be afraid to ask the Lord for the help. Don't make the assumption that, well, the Lord owes it to you, because he don't. He give you a fair shake when he hung between heaven and earth.
Yes.
And early on the third day, he rose. The rest of it now is up to you and I to call on the name of the Lord. Thank God the Holy Ghost still will wake you up and put somebody on your heart to pray. Huh? Come on. How many knows that the Holy Ghost will tell you maybe go join yourself to this person and just lay your hand and pray over them because they're sick and you ain't talked to them. You didn't know, had no idea they were sick. But when you got there and you told them what the Lord did, and here you are, amen. And God said, you got this infirmity, and God said, I'm going to heal you. Man, I want to tell you, the healing started right there before the hand ever touched. Come on, because somebody brought somebody's faith up alive. Come on, stand on your feet. Give the Lord a good clap tonight. Let me say that first part one more time. When the uproar ceases, I believe this morning some people left out of here that the uproar ceased right here this morning. Wasn't that a beautiful sight? They couldn't get that crowded across the front here kneeling, and then you had another two rows standing. Back in the old days, when they marched into battle to a drum, there was a lot of times that that front line would drop to one knee and position themselves while the rest of the army is standing. Sometimes they would shoot. They would either back up, or the ones standing behind them would just simply get in front of them, or they got out of the way and they would drop to one knee and shoot. It was a lot of carnage like that. It was later on when they found out that the aggressive way, the style of rushing an opposing army was more effective. But I thought about that today. After I would just rehearse, when I get home, a lot of times I just want to rehearse. I just want to take it all in, because at the moment I'm crawling across the congregation, the platform, crawling around praying for people. I'm wore out, and I want to encourage you. You're full of the Spirit of God. Listen, get your praying done. Coming down here and pray when you first get here to be ready to be put off into the war, to be used as a soldier of the Lord to help pray. Amen. Because I want to tell you, the more comes, the more we need more prayer warriors. Come on. And I want to tell you, but as we were doing that, I saw him standing there. I just kind of saw what I studied in history books before. It's a beautiful thing when a people can come together as a body. Amen. It's a beautiful thing when people can come in and get into one mind and one accord. And now I put my need to the side, that maybe I can be a part of meeting somebody else's need. Oh, glory to God. You're going to have trouble in this life. That's my promise. But I want to promise you something else, that no matter how much trouble you have, it's not too big for God. That's where your faith has got to be intact. Quit believing the lie of that enemy. Dear God, let's pray. Won't you come across the front of this church and just lift your hands and say, "Oh Lord, you see me in this troubling time." If you want to bow a knee to the platform, you can do that too. Amen. And when you get prayed up, why don't you find somebody? Amen. Encourage him in prayer. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Lord, we need to come on. Come on, talk to the Lord.